Hi, it's Sylvan. Today I'm going to show you how to use the Revolve function in Autodesk Inventor. Here I'm using the Autodesk Inventor 2021, so maybe if you have the older or the newer version, you might see the UI is kind of different, but the function is basically the same, so don't worry. First thing that you have to do before create a body is make a new part file. So let's go to the top and click this drop down menu here and click part. The basic of Revolve function, as you can see here, is create a feature or body by revolving sketch profiles about an axis. So usually Revolve is being used when you want to make a cylindrical shape like a shaft or disc. So now we're going to make a profile by click start 2D sketch here, or you can also press the S button on your keyboard. It's gonna save your time by using the keyboard shortcut. Just click one of this origin plane, and now we're on the sketch mode. Let's just make a simple sketch here. Click dimension tool to make a dimension, or just press D on your keyboard. And then click finish sketch. Click revolve. Because there are two close profile here, you have to select the profile manually. Click here to select the axis. We're gonna make a shaft, so select this line as the axis. That's it. We just made a shaft by using the revolve function. Let's see if we select the other line as an axis. Edit the function by double-click the revolution one in the model browser, like on the previous video. Or you can just click one of the face of this body and click here. And then the revolve menu is popping up. Click here to change the axis, then click this line as the axis. I'm gonna make this revolution 180. So the option can be seen easily. As you can see, like the extrude function, this function also has some option here, but because this is the first body that we're gonna make, only behavior option are being shown now. There are four direction here. The default option make your revolution goes this way. You can drag the arrow here or just fill the exact amount dimension on the box. Then there is also flip, if you want your revolution goes this way. Symmetrical, if you want your revolution go to both direction by dividing the angle to equal amount. And then we have asymmetrical, if you want it go to the both side with different amount of angle. But first, let's just use the default and full option. Go ahead, let's say we're gonna make a groove surrounding this circle. Click start 2D sketch. Select XY plane. F7 to cut across the body. I wanna make the groove has triangular shape, so click on the drop down menu here and select the polygon. Fill this box with 3 to make a triangle. You know, you can make the revolution axis by projecting one of the axes. Select the axis that you think it is suitable, then click project geometry. So now you can see that the projection of the axis turned into this line. Select the line, click center line tool here, and you can see that yellow line turned into a center line. And if you create a dimension from this center line to this triangle, the dimension automatically become a diameter. Fill it with the amount you want. Then click finish sketch. And when you execute the revolve function, it will select the profile and the axis automatically. And now you can see there are also the boolean option here. Just like the extrude, there are also join, cut, intersection, and new solid option here. Join is used when you want to add a shape or feature by joining the new feature to the current body part. Then cut, which is used when you want to add a shape or feature by subtracting the current body part. And then we have intersection, when you want to get a body by take the interference part of the new feature with the current body part. And the last one is new solid, when you want to make multiple body part on your design. We just want to make a groove here, so select the cut option. Let's say we want to make this groove 180 degree and symmetrical from the sketch plane. And then click OK. Well, that's it. Give it a try and good luck. If you have any question, you can always comment on the comment section below. I'll try to answer all of your questions. See you on the next video.